Good morning, students. How are you? I hope you are all fine. We have completed successfully in the previous term. Is it that the first term we have completed? So today itself we have learned about the second term portions. Okay. So in this term we have learned 5 units. Okay. We have learned 5 units. Today we are going to learn about the unit 8, commercial mathematics. Commercial mathematics. So now commercial mathematics means nothing but life mathematics. Okay. Do you like the dosa? Everyone like. I say like well. So how to make the dosa? How to make? So we make the flour. Is it? Maavu vandu create pannom. So how to make the dosa batter? How to make? So we have required some groceries. What are the groceries needed? We have need the 2 groceries. One is rice, another one is urad dal. Is it urad dal or black dal? We have used to make the dosa batters. Okay. So how to make? We have take some ratios. Is it some ratio we have use it? For example, the both are having the same type of groceries. Is it the both type of material or quantity is the same type? Is it both are in a groceries? Malika jaman solvanga abidane rice um abidha solvanga and also urad dal means urittu ulundan solvanga, black dal means karuppu ulundan solvanga. Okay, so urad dal. So we have take some equal measurements na correct ah adukku evlo venum abingiradha nama exact ah eduthadha we have get the better dosa batter. Correct ah na namak measurement la edutha madha we got a perfect dosa, otherwise is not got a perfect dosa. Okay, so for example the rice in a ratio always measured by east. Okay, so our rice is to urad dal, right? Dal or black dal, any one of the dal. Okay, right. So the rice we have considered 800 gram is to the urad dal we have considered 200 gram. So both having the same type of quantities, the groceries. Okay, we have compare the 2 quantities. Which are the quantities? Rice and urad dal. Okay, so this kind of comparison is called ratio. This type of comparison is called the ratio. Okay, so what is the definition of ratio? Already we have learned in the 6th standard. What is the definition of ratio? Comparison of 2 quantities as a same type, as a same type is called the ratio. Today we are going to learn about ratio, proportion. Already we have learned proportion. We have briefly learned about the proportion. Okay, and how to find out the 3rd proportion, 4th proportion, and mean proportion. In this year we have learned. Okay, shall we move? Yes. First one, ratio. What is the definition? Right, the ratio ratio is a numerical relation of one quantity to another quantity of the same type. Okay, so ratio is a numerical relation of one quantity to another quantity of the same type. As we see the one of the example also. Okay, so both having the grocery same type. Okay, compare the two quantities. Which are the quantities we have compared in the example? Rice and red dal. Okay. So perfectly we have take some ratio, we get the perfect dosa batter. So the ratio, the definition of ratio, the ratio is a numerical relation of one quantity to another quantity of the same type. Another quantity of the same type is called the ratio. Okay, it is denoted by ist. Okay. Is 2. How can you read? Is 2. Okay. Is 2. Okay. And then this is a comparison of two numbers and you this is a comparison two numbers and the numbers. Comparison of two numbers and the numbers which form the ratio are called as terms, called terms. Okay, is called the terms. So ratio of rice to the dal, urad dal, we have considered the ratio is 800 gram, is it? Rice is to dal. Example, the ratio, how can you write? 800 gram is to 200 gram. That's the ratio. That is a ratio. Okay, right. And next one, proportion. So simpler ratio always can be written in the simplest form. Okay, another one of that point. Every ratio. Okay, can be represented in the form of a fraction. Okay, so every ratio can be represented in the form of fraction and it is reducible to the lowest form or simplest form. Okay, every ratio can be represented in the form of a fraction and it is reducible to the lowest form. So what is the definition of a ratio? A ratio is a comparison of two quantities as a same type. Okay. So the ratio is the numerical relation of one quantity to the another quantity of the same type. It is denoted by ist. Okay. And then this is a comparison of two numbers. Comparison of, in a numerical we have compared the two numbers, 800 gram and 200 gram. So comparing two numbers and the number which of the form the ratio is called the terms. This is called the terms. Okay, and another one of the form, every ratio, okay, can be represented in the form of fraction. Can be represented in the form of fraction and it is reducible to the lowest form. Should reduce to the lowest form. Enna ratio kudutano adu evlo simplest form la ezhuda mudiyumo or lowest form la ezhudanumo ezhudanum seriya, right. And next one of that, proportion. Okay, proportion means comparison of two ratios. Here comparison of two quantities is called the ratio. Proportion means comparison of two ratios. Comparison of two ratios is called the proportions. Okay, see, proportion. Okay, so what is the definition of proportion? The comparison of two ratios. Comparison of two ratios is called the proportions. Okay, when two ratios are equal, the term are said to be in proportion. If A by B is equal to C by D, where A, B, C, D are proportion, or proportion, and can be written as, and it can be written as A is to B equal and simple. Okay, this is called the proportion. Okay, C is to D. Okay, the numbers A and D are called the extremes. Here A and D are called extremes. And then B and C. Here B and C are called means. Or middle value. Middle term. Okay. Mean or middle term. Okay, so proportion means when two ratios are equal. Okay, the terms are said to be a proportion. If A by B is equal to C by D, where A, B, C, D are in proportion, and it can be written as A is to B equal and C is to D. Here A and D are called the extremes. Here B and C are called the mean or middle values. Okay, A by B is equal to C by D. We have cross multiply. What we get? A into D is equal to B into C. So A and D are called the extremes. That is, the product of extremes is equal to B and C are called the means. Product of means. From this proportion, okay, A, B, C, D are proportion, then the product of A into D is equal to B into C. That is, the product of extreme is equal to product of mean, product of mean. Okay, and then when three terms A, B, C are in continuous or continued proportion. Okay, when the three terms A, B, C are continued proportion. Okay, continued proportion. Continued proportion. Then A by B is equal to B by C. B by C. Now cross multiply. That is B squared is equal to B into B. B squared is equal to A into C. Equal to AC. Here B is called the mean proportion. Okay. A, B is called the mean proportion of A and C. Okay. Here B is called the mean proportion and C is called the third proportion. A and B. Okay, D is called the fourth proportion. Okay, proportion means A by B is equal to C by D. Okay, A, B, C, D are in proportion. Okay, then A into D is equal to B into C. That is the product of extreme is equal to a product of mean. Okay, when the three terms A, B, C are in continued proportion, then A by B is equal to B by C, that is B square is equal to AC. Here B is called the mean proportion and C is called the third proportion of A and B. A and B. D is called the fourth proportion. D is called the fourth proportion. Okay. Sometimes asking find the fourth proportion. Okay. That's it. Now see the example one. What are the things we have learned? Which are the concepts we have learned? Ratio, proportion, and proportion in proportion, mean proportion, third proportion, and fourth proportion. Is it? So ratio means comparison of two quantities. This same type is called the ratio. And then proportion means comparison of two ratios. Comparison of two ratios is called the proportion. And then the product of A, B, C, D are the in proportion. Then the product of extreme is equal to product of mean. And then when the three terms A, B, C are in the continued proportion, then A by B is equal to B by C. Then B squared is equal to AC. B is called the mean proportion. And C is called the third proportion. D is called the fourth proportion. And C is the third proportion to A and B. A and B. Okay, I hope you all understood this concept. Now move to the example problems. Example 1. If a water tank is filled by a pipe at the rate of 40 liter per minute, how much water will be filled in 25 minutes? Filled in 25 minutes. So what are the data are given? Example 1. Solution. The time and quantity is given. Okay. The time. Comparison of two quantities. Time and quantity of water. Is it? So first 1 minute. 1 minute. How many liters? 40 liters. Proportion 25 minutes. The quantity is x liter. X liter. Okay, so ratio can be written as 1/40 is equal to 25/x. Now cross multiply, x is equal to 25 × 40. Okay, 25 × 4 = 100, added 0. So how many liters we have needed for 25 minutes? 1000 liters. 1000 liters. Now see the revision exercise. Find the ratio, easiest one. Find the ratio of the following. First one, 3 dozen to 8 dozen. Division exercise. The first one, find the ratio 3 dozens and 2 compared to the 8 dozens. Both types of quantities are equal. So how can you write? 3 is to solution only you have, right? Okay. You will write the question in your classwork note. After write the answer. Okay. 3 is to 8. Okay. First one. And B, 24. Both in the same type. The rupees is given. Okay. So 24 rupees is 73 rupees. And C, 6 months to 11 months. That is 6 is to 11. And D, 3 months a year. Okay. D and 3 months to a year. So a year means 1 year. So 1 year, how many months had? How many months have it? It have 12 months. So compare here month and month only. Here different types are given. So we have changed to the same type after compare the quantities. Okay. So 3 months to 1 year, how many months? 12 months. 12 months. So 3 is to 12. Okay. And the ratio shouldn't write it simplest form. Okay. Can you simplify this? Yes. It can return as, that is 1 is to 4. Okay. Right. And E, 65 pies. 2 rupees, 5 rupees is given. Rupees 5 is given, so we have changed to the pies. So 65 pies, 2. So 1 rupee, how many pies? 100 pies. Here 5. So 500 pies. 1 rupee is equal to 100 pies. Okay. Now we have right 65 is to 500. It cancel. So 13 is to 100. 13 is to 100. And F1. 12 meter to 85 centimeter. Okay. So here meter is given, here centimeter is given. So we have changed to centimeter. So meter to centimeter, we have multiply meter deci centi milli. Okay, so how many times? 1, 2. So 100 we have to multiply. So 12 × 100 = 85. Centimeter. So 1200 centimeter to 85 centimeter. Compare the numerals in ratio 85. It cancel in 5 table. 17 here, 2, 4. So 240 is 17 is the answer. Okay. And second one, which of the following forms are proportion? So what we do, proportion means the given 2, 9, 8, 36 in proportion. How can you write in the proportion? 2, 9, 8, 36. So we have considered A, B, C, D. So proportion, how can you write? A is to B, C is to equal and C is to D. Okay. So A value is 2 is to 9. Proportion 8 is to 36. That is 2 by 9 is equal to 8 by 36. Can you cancel? 9 fours are 36. It cancel in 2 table. 4 twos are 8. It also cancel. So we get the value is 1 equal to 1. So given number is proportion. Remaining problems homework. Okay. Therefore 2, 9, 8 or 4 ma proportion. Okay. So remaining problems homework. Third one, find the value of x for which the following ratio are in the proportion. The given proportion, easiest one. Already given in the form of the proportion, you have write in the fraction. The proportion can be written equal x by 25. Now simplify. So just cross multiply. So x equal to 50. Okay, remaining problems homework, the same method. And fourth one, find the mean proportion between 25 and 400. Okay, and mean proportion, what is the formula? B squared is equal to AC. Is it? Here A and C value is given. You have to find out the mean proportion. So mean proportion, B squared is equal to AC. Here A is equal to 25, C is equal to 400, is it? Okay. So substitute the values, 25 into 400. So 25 fours are 100, added 2 zeros. B square, we have find out the B. B is called the mean proportion. Take the square root. Get the value. B is equal to 100. The mean proportion B is equal to 100. Okay. And fifth one, the ratio between two numbers is 9 is to 5 and their sum is 448. Find that number. So common ratio BX. Let common ratio BX. So given the sum of the ratio. Is equal to 448. So 9x plus 5x is equal to 448. So 14x equal to 448. Okay. So x equal to 448 by 14. 3s are, and then 2, 28, right? So x equal to 32. X equal to 32. Find the numbers. So first number is 9x. So 9 into 32. Another one of the number is 5x. So 5 into x value is 32. $288, and another one of the number 32, 160. Right, that's it. And 6th one, find the third proportion to 1 kilometer, 500 kilometer, and 300 kilometer. Okay, that's meaning third proportion means, what is the formula? B square AC equal to AC. Okay, C is called the third proportion. So what are the values are given? First 1 kilometer. Okay, I will do that. 6 1. Third proportion. Third is equal to B square is equal to AC. Okay, so the first value we have considered here, A is equal to 1500. Okay, B is equal to 300. Okay, now substitute the values. B squared value was 300, the whole squared is equal to A value was 1500 into C. We have find out the third proportion. Okay, so 9. So 3 squared 9. Okay, so 2 0 square panama, we get the 4 squares. Okay, so 0 0 0 0 divided by here, the product is the move to this side, division by using the transpose method equal to C. Simplify, how many times? 15. 16. So C is equal to 16. Thus the third proportion is equal to 16. Okay. And 7 and 8 is a homework. Okay. So homework. Second B and C, third B and C, seven and eight. Okay, I hope you are understood the today concept, ratio, proportion, mean proportion, and continued proportion. Which one is called the continued proportion? The mean proportion is called the continued proportion, is it? If the three numbers are continued, A, which are the numbers? A, B, C are continued proportion, then B is called the mean proportion, okay? And then C is called the third proportion, D is called the fourth proportion. I hope you are understood today concept. If you have any doubt, you can ask it to me. Thank you, students.